This four-year-old drone startup from Lucknow launched an unmanned aerial vehicle to a record-breaking altitude of 9,797 meters above sea level. And to put that into perspective, that's higher than Mount Everest, which stands at 8,850 meters, making Kalam Labs the first Indian drone startup to achieve something like this. Welcome to our weekly Indian Startup News Show. I'm Caleb Friesen, your host, and you're watching Backstage with Millionaires. And before we dive in, this channel is part of the 01 Network by Zirota. Okay, now coming back to Kalam Labs here, what makes this feat even more remarkable is that this UAV has a wingspan of less than 2 meters and it weighs under 4 kilos. And now they're actually aiming even higher, 30,000 meters above sea level. And if they're successful, it would be among the highest UAV flights ever achieved globally. Now, Kalam Labs was founded by Ahmad Faraaz and his former classmates from BITS Pilani, Sashakt Tripathi, and Harshit Awasthi. And they're developing this technology specifically for India's armed forces to enhance surveillance capabilities. But let's take a look at how their mission Everest, which is not the official term, how it unfolded. The UAV took off from a Himalayan base at around 2,700 meters altitude, climbing past rugged terrain, extreme cold, and high winds. Temperatures dropped from 20 degrees Celsius at launch to minus 60 degrees at the highest point, while the UAV faced winds of up to 50 kilometers per hour and a drastic pressure drop of over 70%. And despite the severe weather conditions, the UAV remained stable thanks to its advanced design and an onboard AI navigation system. And this is the system that allows it to operate without any human control, making it ideal for missions in remote or hostile areas. And it's not just altitude. In an earlier test, this drone was carried to a height and then released for a guided return. And it flew back at 800 kilometers per hour with an amazing precision, landing within less than 1 meter of its target. All right, next up in the news, Zoho has just acquired Kochi-based Asimov Robotics, a startup that's known for its humanoid robots and industrial automation systems. And this announcement comes on the same day that Zoho opened up its new research and development campus in Kodarakara, Kerala. And both moves are part of Zoho's bigger push into artificial intelligence, robotics, and advanced technologies. And Zoho's co-founder and CEO, Shailesh Dave, said that the goal is to drive innovation from rural India while solving complex tech challenges. And so to support this vision, Zoho has also teamed up with the Kerala Startup Mission to launch a Deeptech product studio. This initiative will help startups and researchers to work on cutting-edge technologies, with Zoho providing mentorship and hands-on support. But that's not all, because Zoho is also collaborating with more than half a dozen other companies and institutions, and these partnerships cover a wide range of fields, everything from clean energy and semiconductors to healthcare and advanced materials. All right, next up in the news, Bengaluru-based SatSure and Hyderabad's Dhruva Space have signed a partnership to deliver end-to-end Earth observation services. And their goal here is to offer advanced solutions for both defense and government missions, as well as industries like agriculture, energy, and aviation. Simply put, it's about using satellites to collect data on what's happening here on Earth. And these satellites capture high-resolution images that show everything from crop conditions and infrastructure to weather patterns and disaster zones. But it doesn't stop there, because this raw data is then processed and analyzed using advanced technology, including artificial intelligence, to generate useful insights. And as part of their deal, Dhruva Space will take care of the satellite part, building, launching, and operating the satellites that capture the images, and then SatSure subsidiary, Kylead EO, will step in to analyze that data and deliver clear, ready-to-use information to their customers. And this means that governments and businesses can simply subscribe to the service and get everything that they need without having to manage satellites or data analysis themselves. All right, next up in the news, the government of India has officially approved a massive research and innovation fund worth 1 lakh crore rupees. And this isn't just another policy announcement. This fund is designed to tackle one of the biggest challenges that deep tech startups face in India: funding. Deep tech startups, which work on technologies like AI, advanced hardware, and semiconductors, usually have a long development cycle and need patient capital. But most investors shy away from these high-risk, long-term bets. And that's where this new fund comes in. It'll provide long-term financing financing at extremely low or even zero interest rates, especially for projects in critical sectors like defense tech, clean energy, and strategic technologies. And the fund also includes a dedicated deep tech fund of funds aiming at supporting high-risk, high-reward innovations. Now, here's how the money will actually flow. First, a special purpose fund will hold the 1 lakh crore rupees, and then from there, the money will go to selected fund managers who will then invest in projects through long-term loans or even equity, especially for startups. And the goal here is to create an ecosystem where Indian startups can take risks and build world-class innovations without having to worry about capital. All right, next up in the news, the government of India, once again, we're talking a lot about government this week, but the government has just announced the Motor Vehicle Aggregator Guidelines 2025 with the goal of imposing stricter rules for apps like Ola, Uber, and Rapido. So first up, surge pricing here. Platforms can now charge no more than twice the base fare. And it's the states that will actually set the base fare, each individual state. But until then, companies must follow their declared rates. But another big updated part of these guidelines is that bike taxis have also been officially recognized. For the first time ever, states can now allow non-transport motorcycles for passenger rides, something that has been a problem for especially Rapido in Karnataka. The government has also set clear targets for electric vehicle adoption in ride-hailing fleets, with states or air quality bodies deciding the exact numbers. A driver pay is another key change. Drivers will now be entitled to at least 80% of the fare if they own the vehicle, and 60% if the aggregator owns it. And the payment must happen every 2 weeks or sooner. There's also a fine for cancellations, up to 10% of the fare for both drivers and passengers if they cancel without valid reasons. All right, now let's move into some quick news here. First of all, Swiggy has just shut down their B2B service Minis, which allowed restaurants to create their digital storefronts on Swiggy. Then we have logistics startup Shadowfax filing their confidential DRHP, and it's expected that they'll raise anywhere between 2,000 and 2,500 crore rupees through their IPO. And then talking about IPOs, cloud kitchen brand Cure Foods has also filed their DRHP, and they're planning to raise 800 crore rupees in their IPO. All right, moving on now here, and just one more segment here before we get into the funding news. Just like last week, I asked you all if you had launched anything awesome this week, and a lot of you replied. And so here are my three picks for this week. The first one here is opticalspacetools.space by Vishesh, and it's a fun interactive space where you can explore how satellites work. You can zoom in on Earth, see how satellites capture images, and even play around with things like pixel sizes and coverage areas too. It's kind of like a video game, but for learning about space and Earth observation. And it's super handy if you're curious about how weather forecasts or satellite maps are made, or if you're just a space nerd. Next, we have hyperlister.com by Biush. It basically helps you to create a waitlist for your startup or product without any coding or tech stuff. You just drag and drop to make your page in under a minute, and then you can collect emails from people who are interested, track how many signups you're getting, and share your waitlist link right away. And then finally, there's AcmeBot, an AI SEO agent and diagram generator by Abhishek. And it helps you to boost your website search rankings by picking the best keywords for Google. But here's the fun part. It also makes diagrams and charts to go along with your content. So it not only gets more people to your site, but it also makes your posts look way more engaging too. All right, now let's move to the funding news segment for today's video. This week, Indian startups raised a total of $280 million, which is significantly higher than last week's $179 million. And it's also above the trend line. So great job, everybody. So now let's take a look at some of the companies that raised funds this week. The first one I want to talk about here is Bengaluru-based B2B marketplace for food and grocery products, Jumbotail. And if you run a Kirana store, instead of calling multiple suppliers or visiting markets, you can just use Jumbotail's app to order things like rice, oil, snacks, soap, and get it delivered directly to your shop. And they also help owners, shop owners specifically, with things like credit and even offering tools to help them run their store better, like billing systems and inventory management through their J24 program. And they've raised $120 million in their Series D round, turning them into a unicorn. Then after that, we have Bengaluru-based Zango AI. It helps banks and financial companies deal with complicated rules and regulations using AI. And normally companies have to spend a lot of time and money reading through boring legal documents and making sure that they're following all of the rules. And Zango AI makes this easy by building and training smart AI agents that can read, understand, and explain these rules automatically. And they've raised $4.8 million in their seed round. Following that, we have Bengaluru-based Mayotic Semiconductor, which helps chip designers build complex chips faster using AI. So normally designing chips, especially analog chips, the ones that deal with things like sound, sensors, and power, take weeks or even months. It's super technical and very slow, but Mayotic is building an AI tool that acts like a co-pilot for engineers. It automatically creates designs, catches mistakes early on, and suggests better ways to build the chip. And they've raised $4.15 million in their seed round. Next up, we have a Bengaluru-based biotech startup called Loopworm that's using insects to turn waste into valuable and sustainable products. They take leftover food and farm waste, and instead of throwing it away, they feed it to insects like silkworms and black soldier flies, and then they turn these insects into high-protein products like oils and powders, which are used in fish feed, chicken feed, pet food, and even cosmetics and fertilizers. And they raised $3.25 million in their pre-series A round. And then finally, we have Bengaluru-based deep tech startup Simware, which is redesigning how data centers work. Normally, in a data center, you have separate machines for storage, computing, and networking, and it's expensive, bulky, and tricky to manage all of this. And so Simware has built a single smart box called Sim that combines all of this in one. And the cool part here is that you can easily adjust how much computing or storage you need, kind of like rearranging apps on your phone, but for servers. And it also saves a ton of electricity and space as well. And so they raised $2.3 million in their pre-series A round. All right, that is all the Indian startup news that I have for you all this week. I'm Caleb Friesen, and this has been Backstage with Millionaires. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.